Hello friends, welcome to another tutorial of Sapien Vlog. If you haven't subscribed my channel yet, kindly subscribe, comment and do like. In this video, we'll talk about plasma membrane, its role and its structure. So let's start with the function of plasma membrane. It is dynamic, which means that it is available in each and every living organism, which we can see around us. Also, it is a fluid structure. By fluid structure, it means that it is flexible in nature. It forms external boundary of cell. It means that it creates a boundary between interior of cell and surroundings of cell. This protects the cell integrity. It is also known as selectively permeable membrane, which means that it allows only certain kind of molecules to pass inside and outside of the cell. It also regulates molecular traffic across the boundary. However, this function is related with selectively permeable thing. So it can control the molecules at a particular time. As it is selectively permeable, so it can decide which molecules can move through the plasma membrane. If we look at the structure of plasma membrane, it somehow looks like this in 3D microscope. In these two, you can see that this structure is magnified here. Here, you can see the bristle-like structure. These are forming bilayer across with the heads on their terminal end. Here also you can see the bristles like structure arranged like that, and head part you can see like that. When we talk about the structure of plasma membrane, it looks like that. Here you can see that the plasma membrane comprises of lipid bilayer. So lipid bilayer means that there are two layers of lipid. So lipid is like that. So this is the head of lipid and this is the tail of lipid. So here we can see two layers are there for lipids, and proteins are also present here and here. Some are attached to the head part and some are embedded in between the lipid bilayer. So those which are attached to the head part superficially, these are known as peripheral protein, and those are embedded in the bilayer structure, these are known as integral protein. Also, some carbohydrates are also present in case of the plasma membrane. However, it can be attached to the lipids or protein, and they form chain-like structure mostly. So if we talk about this structure, we can see the maximum proportion is covered by the lipids and protein. However, only some of the portion, we can see that the presence of carbohydrate in this plasma membrane structure. Coming to the discovery of plasma membrane structure. So in 1972, Jonathan Singer, he looks like that, and Garth Nicholson, they proposed fluid mosaic model together. So on the left hand side, you can see Jonathan Singer, and on the right hand side, you can see Garth Nicholson. So they were in association with each other. They were doing research at that time, and they proposed their discovery in the form of fluid mosaic model. So this model is related with the behavior of plasma membrane. How does plasma membrane look like? What are the important features? How we can study the various aspects of plasma membrane? We got idea through their discovery. So let's go. Let's get started with the special features of fluid mosaic model. So since it were discovered by the singer Ann Nicholson, it is widely accepted model. It is followed worldwide in every country whenever they talk about the specific concept plasma membrane. Here in this model, membrane are viewed as quasi fluid like structure. Quasi means that here we can see different kinds of biomolecules. They are arranged together and their arrangement promotes flexibility in case of plasma membrane movement. Also, proteins are embedded in lipid bilayer. We have just seen it can be this one. Can you tell me which one is this? It is integral. Because it is embedded in lipid bilayer and some of them are attached superficially to the upper side, which is known as peripheral proteins. So this kind of structure promotes fluid movement of lipid and proteins. So in fact, whenever these structures are connected, the biomolecules are in association, they promote the movement of each other, but up to limited extent. Otherwise, if limit is not there, structure can collapse. Coming to the next point, we have fatty acyl chain of lipid bilayer. It forms hydrophobic region. So the meaning is that we know that lipid has head and a tail. So this tail is fatty acyl chain. So this basically forms hydrophobic portion inside the bilayer. Hydrophobic means that water hating, or we can say that water sensitive. And integral membrane protein float in this lipid bilayer. Both biomolecules, proteins and lipid, they move laterally in the plane of bilayer. Laterally means like that, on sideways. So they can move sideways in the plane of bilayer. Now, let's learn about the ratio of protein and lipid. Basically, it varies in the plasma membrane. It really depends on the cell type, whether it is eukaryotic, prokaryotic, plant cell, animal cell, and in between different animal species, different plant variety. So the ratio varies. Let's see the example. So as you can see here, these are human red blood cells or RBCs. Here, the percentage of lipid is 43 and of protein is 49. But in case of mouse liver cell, so these are the microscopic structures you can see on the screen. In case of mouse liver cell, the lipid percentage is 54 and the protein percentage is 43. So as we can see here, in RBC, lipid is comparatively less in percentage. And in case of mouse, proteins are comparatively less in percentage. So from here, we can get the idea like ratio varies. So the deviations can be there when we compare different types of cells. When we talk about carbohydrate, we know that their percentage is comparatively very low when we compare it with lipid or protein. So the percentage is around 5 to 10. So carbohydrate have special behavior. So whenever they bound to proteins, they form glycoproteins. So here, as you can see, this part, Carbohydrate is bound to the protein. This will make the structure of glycoprotein. And whenever carbohydrates, they bound with the lipid, this structure, so they can make glycolipid. So also carbohydrates, whenever they connect in chains. When we talk about different cell types, so the important point to be considered here is that carbohydrates are abundant in eukaryotes. That means their percentage is higher in case of eukaryotes than in prokaryotes, plasma membrane. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, kindly subscribe, comment, and do share as much as you can.